this video series, I'm going to be making a cabinet for drill bits. The video is going to be in a couple of parts, and I haven't made the second part yet, so please make sure you're subscribed if you want to watch that when it comes out. So this first video will be making the actual drawers to go inside, and then the second part will be making the case to take the drawers. And the drawers themselves, you can see in the photographs here, and the idea with this was to make a really nice cabinet and get rid of all those kind of horrible plastic boxes that you tend to get with drill bits. The first thing that I did before I got started, which you can see here, was to actually design all the trays on the computer so that I knew where everything was going to be going, because I thought if I just started making the drawers, I would most probably get in a bit of a mess. So I wanted to make sure that everything would definitely fit once I got everything, everything ready to go inside. So you can see me making a start on the first drawer here, and the first thing to do was to cut all the pieces down and lay out the dovetails. And the wood I'm using here is oak, and it's actually leftover flooring from the workshop, which I've then cut down to a suitable size. And to cut the dovetails, I'm using these little handy guides. These are made by a guy called David Barron, and they're very handy if you want to do some, some dovetails and you're not super confident at doing them freehand. And if you are interested in learning woodwork, I wouldn't suggest that you try and learn by watching me doing this. There's lots of great people on YouTube with videos. I'm very much trying to just learn myself. This is for entertainment only. So I'm probably doing a lot of things wrong if you, if you actually know what you're doing about woodwork. One of the things that's quite difficult for me with these dovetails is that I'm in the shed here, and the piece of kind of worktop that I have in there isn't really a proper bench, so it's not very solid. So trying to do the chiseling part of this, the bench top tends to bounce up and down. It's not an ideal thing to be doing. I have since bought a much better quite a fancy coping saw that lets you cut very close to the line with these, and that reduces the amount of chiseling to do. But I did actually film this quite a long time ago, to be honest, so some things have changed since then. So that's all the dovetails complete, and I'm now moving on to the interior sections. Here I'm transferring all the measurements from the computer drawing onto the actual wood, ready to route out the little slots for the dividers. And something that I really did need for this project was a router table, so that I could have actually moved the pieces of wood over the router blade. It was very, very difficult trying to keep everything lined up because they're so small, and actually routing them directly like this. So that was a lesson learned. Here I'm trying to actually route slots in the dividers themselves, because other dividers meet them at right angles in various places. And again, this was very, very difficult trying to actually use the router directly like this. What you can see here is the base of the drawer ready to go in, and I've had to take a little bit of a shaving off the edge because I had a 3mm router bit and I bought some 3mm plywood naively thinking that it would just slot in. It turns out that the manufacturing tolerances on plywood are about plus minus 10%, so the plywood was actually about 3.3mm and it just wouldn't go into the slots. I was also going to use plywood for a lot of the interior dividers, but I had the same problem, so I ended up using hardwood, which ultimately looked nicer anyway. Here I'm just gluing the drawers together, so that is plywood that's going in for the base, but I got some oak stain for it and applied some of that to make it match the sides, and I think it looks quite nice actually. It's given quite a nice good effect. So with the bottom and the sides all glued together, I can now move on to actually gluing in the dividers. Now, it's quite a challenge to remember which way around these all went, because as you can see, they've got various different slots cut in various different places. So it went together a bit like a jigsaw. And the next thing to do is just to try and true up the dovetails and plane the edges of the drawers nice and smooth. So once everything's planed, I can just clean up the outsides and then apply the finish to the outsides as well. And I'm just giving it a clean with a little bit of white spirit first. I do like doing this as well because it makes the grain of the wood pop out, and you can kind of get a preview of what it's going to look like once it's got all the finish applied. So the next thing to do is just to glue in the little knobs for the front of the drawers. Now I did order these from a woodworking supplier as little cabinet knobs, but to me, of course, they look like Sam Brown studs for leather work as well. And I'm going a bit belt and braces with these. They've got epoxy on the back and Loctite on the front, because there would be no way to actually access the screws once the drawers are complete, so I really didn't want them to be moving in the future. So each drawer is for a different type of drill bits, and here you can see me starting work on the one for spade bits. This really took quite a long time to figure out exactly how I wanted these to fit in here, because they're a little bit of a funny shape and I wanted them to sit in the drawer without sort of flopping about all over the place as well. Here I'm just doing a little bit of testing on some scrap to try and find the router bit which works best for making the slots for these before I make them on the proper drawers. And once again, I can't emphasize enough how much I should have been using a router table for this. Trying to push the router along the engineer square like that is really fraught with danger, because if you move slightly away from it, then you kind of make a wonky channel. So it really would have been much easier with a router table. And you can see here that I made all the cuts in a single piece, and then I cut that piece down to form the three sections that we needed, so I knew that everything lined up perfectly. I'm now moving on to the next drawer, which was the general HSS bits. And one of the fiddliest bits for this was in the top left hand corner. I wanted a kind of tray for all the very smallest bits, the, you know, kind of 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter. So I decided to get a block of wood and cut some little channels in, which would make it much easier to get the drill bits out of the drawer. And you can see by this stage that I'd learned that the router technique wasn't really working. So I actually made myself a little slot cutting jig, and used the collar that came with the router, and that gave me much better results, if not exactly perfect. And this is that completed block then being glued up into the corner of that drawer. And I was ultimately very pleased with this. As I say, it may not look absolutely perfect, but I think it was a good idea. It's certainly much easier to get these bits out than it would be if they were in the very bottom of the channels. And for this drawer to complete it, I'm now gluing in all the main dividers. As I say, these were originally going to be plywood, and then because the plywood was too thick for the channels that I'd cut, I had to actually source some suitably, you know, dimensioned hardwood for it. I don't have all the tools here to make thin boards like this, so I got these from a hobby shop, and they seem to work quite well. And then once they've actually been installed, I'm just planing everything nice and flat on the top. And here you can see that drawer complete now with all the finishes applied and nicely tidied up. So the final thing which I did with these, which was quite ambitious, was to actually inlay some brass strips with all the numbers on for the, you know, the sizes of the drill bits. I wanted this to look quite nice. I didn't really want to just write on the wood. I didn't want to try and use pyrography because I thought it would look neat and so on. So this was the method that I came up with. So to make the channel for the brass, I used the router again, which again was quite fiddly balancing it on there. And then I just had to square up the ends of the cuts in order to get a kind of long rectangular channel. So here I am starting to make the brass strips, and to do this I worked out the spacing on the computer and then printed in reverse the numbers that I needed. And what this let me do was use some acetone to actually then transfer the toner from the paper onto the brass, and this was just a way of giving a nice accurate guide for the stamping. And then to stamp the letters, I'm using some metal imprinting stamps. And to make sure that everything was nice and vertical and square, a friend who I was working with at the time cut on his, he had a little kind of a CNC lathe thing in his garage. It made me a little jig to help line the stamp up and place over the brass so that I could get a really good impression. And then once I'd actually made the impressions, I blackened them down with industrial Sharpie and baked them in the oven, which are all things that I've covered in a video on metal imprinting, in case it's anything that you're interested in. And with those strips complete, I could give them a little clean up again with the acetone, and then I stuck them in using VHB tape. Now that stands for very high bonding, and it's essentially super strong double-sided tape. It's what Chris Reeve knives use for putting the inlays into the Sebenzas. I remember seeing in a video. So when I did this, I remember thinking, well, if it's, you know, if it's good enough for them, it's good enough for me. So I used that to put them in, and they haven't gone anywhere since. It seemed to work quite well. And that's it for part one of the video. So thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed that. If you would like to watch me make the actual cabinet which these drawers go inside, then please subscribe to the channel, turn on the notifications if you want to, and then when I actually get around to finishing this off next year sometime, you'll see that video as well. Okay, see you next time.